I'd like to give a warm Valentine's welcome to my viewers in 65 countries around the globe. Stay tuned. Today I'm going to reveal some of my Valentine's crushes for 2016. Welcome to Conscious Capitalism Meets Entertainment Tonight. I'm Sandra Rupp, your anchor host. Politics, business, world events, celebrities. We need to know who is Liam Neeson going out with on Valentine's Day. He did a great job on the Super Bowl ad. I have some dream interviews, some men that I would love to interview for my show. So I'm going to share who those are today and hope that they say yes. I have to have just the right outfit for just the right person. I think this will work for Liam. What do you guys think? This has lace on the bottom. It has lace up here. You can also wear some drop-dead gorgeous dangly earrings. What do you think? In addition, I have a crush on Imran Khan, the future Prime Minister of Pakistan. I love the people in Pakistan who have been following me, as well as those from Saudi Arabia, India, and around the world. I'd like to give you all a warm welcome today. I think you've got a great leader. If Imran comes through this way, or this way, beaded dress, a silk skirt with a lace overlay skirt here. And I've had the opportunity to dine and to meet some of the most powerful people in the entire world. I was at places like the Four Seasons, 21, dinners at Le Cirque. I mean, really, really wonderful places. The little skirt or white evening pants. We do have the Saint John knit suits. Got plenty of those in the closet. So Davos men, just let me know what makes you comfortable. We don't want to leave out Paul. Is actually Paul Polman, CEO of Unilever. Paul is planting trees in Saudi Arabia, and he is helping the people of India. Paul Polman is our leader in sustainability. The whole goal here is to make people more aware of what conscious capitalism, sustainability are, and to get more people interested in the topics. We're bringing glamour to sustainability. If Paul Polman comes through, handmade Indian shawl.
We've got a lot of choices.
We want to get more people interested in the topic, and we want to communicate in a creative way. So just in the past week, I've been on the phone with a global CEO in Dubai. I've been on the phone with Silicon Valley executives. I have been on the phone with executives in New York, a former chief marketing officer, chief innovation officer. Let's see, I've been on the phone with a top hedge fund executive in New York. We all realize that the economy needs a lot of help. We need to invest in more women, especially entrepreneurial women of all ages. So many of the businesses that women are founding are remain one-person companies. We need to invest in these ladies. That truly is our largest economic opportunity worldwide. Normally, I would save this for my French crush, South Beach. I love being at the Eiffel Tower. So that's all I can share with you now about my Valentine's crushes, but I'm going to go on with the show. The whole idea here is to get a great interview, and I found that what you wear with a man does influence how he reacts to you. If you want a man to open up to you, I would say go with something more feminine. In terms of color choice, you might want to go with the pink, the white, more delicate type colors. If you want to go for the power look and debate a man, you're going to want to go for the bright red. That's the most powerful color you can wear. Now, black is a color that really is appealing to everyone. The idea is to look as good as you can because, let's face it, women who wear makeup make more money than women who don't. What do you think, guys? These are people that I would love to interview on camera on my show, Conscious Capitalism Meets Entertainment Tonight. I think it's amazing what women are doing today, and I'd like to see more investment in women-owned businesses. I think that would get our economy rolling very quickly. So I'd encourage you all to take a look at all these options. And thanks for watching. Stay tuned.